I'm reviewing Iron Hammer Digital Trail Camera. I am very excited to show you what I've captured, but first I'm going to show you what it comes with. Now, you have this mount that comes with anchors and screws, as well as an Allen's wrench so you can tighten it up. If you would like something more permanent for your trail camera to be a part of. If not, it comes with an extremely long adjustable strap, and this is what I have been using. And it gives you a large range of trees or posts that have thicker diameters and it can still reach around. It also comes with a USB cable, so that way you can upload your snapshots and your videos onto your PC. And it comes with an audio video cable if you want to plug straight into your television. The waterproof housing is incredible. I was terrified when I had it placed out kind of in a wooded area and we had a severe storm come through. I thought for sure there would be water in the housing, but there is not. You have a place for a lock right here so no one can mess with it. You have your side motion sensors, your front, your lens, and your infrared. This is where you can slide your strap through. You open it up, it comes with a micro SD card that's 8 gigabytes. I currently have 57 videos and 114 photos on this micro USB, and I've only used 1.9 gigabytes, so I still have a lot more that I can store. You have a nice large LCD screen here. You can see the battery life. Now, I have been using this for 4 nights straight and some during the day, so at night I would say it's been about 10 hours of use, and during the day it'd be 8 hours of use, and the batteries it's still almost completely full. This is your replay button, and you can scroll through your snapshots and your videos. Hit menu to delete them all or just the current one. You can activate a slideshow and write protect, and that way you don't accidentally delete it. Menu is your back. Replay gets you right back into the test mode. So the first one that's highlighted is mode. You can click OK and you can decide if you want just photos, video, or photo and video. The next is your photo resolution. You can go up to 12 megapixels and as low as 1. Photo series is how many photos you would like it to take, and I have it set to 2 photos. Video resolution, I currently have it at 1280 720 pixels. You can go up to 1920, 1080, and as low as 320 and 240. Video length, I have it at 10 seconds. But you can go all the way to 10 minutes. Audio recording, you can turn on and off. I currently have it on one. Shot lag is how long you want the motion, once it's triggered, how long you want the camera to wait until it starts taking a photograph or a video. I have it set to 5 seconds. I tried 30 seconds and I didn't catch as much. Side motion sensors, you can turn on and off. sensitivity motion sensors. I have it set to high. Now, when it was storming and the branches were moving and there was a lot of rain and such, it did not pick up any of that. It didn't randomly go off and only went off when there was more of there was more motion with a larger animal. Now, being at the middle sensitivity, I've noticed that if it is a mouse or something that's small like that, about 5 to 6 feet away, it will not pick it up. So it will with the high sensitivity. In high sensitivity, you can pick up, you know, a raccoon or a possum from maybe 300 feet away. Target recording time, you can set it to on, and you can set up when you want it just to automatically start recording and when you want it to stop. Time lapse, you can turn it on, and again you can say for how long you would like it to record to create a time lapse. The first video I have set up during daylight, and I baited some birds in because I wanted something smaller. The camera is located 5 feet away from the feeder. I have video and 2 snapshots. At nighttime, I set it up in my mother's backyard. And I used hot dog buns and spread with peanut butter and a little bowl of cat food to draw in some wildlife. And we were able to capture a raccoon that came in, as well as a very well-fed possum. So you can see the quality of the night vision is clear. It was able to sense the possum from very far away in the dark. I think that this is an incredible camera. I am very excited to show you and demonstrate for you. I hope that this gives you a better idea of their product. Thank you very much for watching. And have a good day.